So, this one is, I'm not going to give it a name because I just threw it together, West Highland Line South. It is with the Black Five High. And I don't think there's anything else to say, is there? Pretty much. We're all here. No stop here. We just need to get moving. Right, let's get the rail driver hooked back up again. I'll do actually Class B for this. This is the Western Lines of Scotland Black 5. We're over speeding, but that's okay. That's okay. Get a brake gauge working here real quick. That'll do. 40 limit now. Francois then, why did he pick this scenario? When he was 4 years old, he moved to Scotland, and then from 4 to 17 lived in a small village called Rue, very close to Helensburgh at the southern end of West Highland Line South. We often used to go up the north by train and do walks on the stunning countryside of Western Scotland. The line runs along Loch Lomond and then Loch Long, two very beautiful lakes, and finally onto Gair Loch, which is where he grew up. And the train line runs along the hillside above the village where he lived when he grew up. They'll point out when he goes when we go past. Yes, this route is before RETB came in. Yeah, those mesh tools actually did the sounds for this one, for the Port Road Black 5. See you later, DJSP. Thanks for joining. What? No Scottish accent? No. Don't want to offend that many people. I'm sure the first time I said I'll play the new, I'd probably get lynched. I've got colleagues up in Scotland. I don't need them getting upset with me for destroying their accent. If I wind the reverser down any more, David, then I'm not going to have any acceleration. We're already slowing down. But we're getting some... I'm going to have to put the reverser forward in a little bit. We're getting boiler pressure back now, which is good. But I can't wind that reverser down anymore. We're already slowing down. We're on 1 in 66 gradient. How efficient is the auto fireman? The auto fireman's really to be basic. So if the fire gets down below a certain point, it'll coal it up to another to the top point, and the same for the water. Which means it'll quite happily, if you're struggling up a steep hill, decide now's a great time to start coaling and watering, rather than keeping the coal efficient and keeping the water topped up all the time. It'll do them, possibly when you don't want them. So that's one of the reasons I think everyone should manually fire. It's just two buttons. You don't have to do anything else, just press two buttons. .35 limit. Apparently we're going downhill now. Not worried about the overspeeding. I'm in a 40 limit now. Probably shouldn't be going over the 40 limit though, should I? Let's turn the regulator off. Put some brake on. Incidentally, Mole Man, did you know that pressing the right trigger, this one, speeds you up, like that? I didn't know that until recently. Release that brake. .97% on the water, we're good. What's the mouse though? There it is. Let it continue to roll, we're gaining some speed. Yeah, it's a Jonathan Lewis route, yeah. Same as Canadian Mountain Passes. And some of Pacific Surf Burner, in fact. No, West Highland Line South is a third party route, yeah. Hey, Gary Luton. What does the regulator do? It regulates steam into the system. It basically is a throttle. The reverser, so the reverser controls, let me come back out here, the reverser controls when in the cycle of backwards and forwards on the system, on the pistons, when steam comes in, yeah, how far along the cycle does the piston go in, so crudely it's forwards and backwards, but actually it controls, it's almost works like a gear. W20, I'm using Xbox controller for the camera. I don't so much use it for driving, I use a rail driver. Wow, this is loud. But I use this for the Xbox, for the cameras. You just got the 1189 trackside, awesome. I'm looking forward to having a play of that. Essentially what happens, Vito, is when you're driving them, you put the regulator up and you want the reverse up full forward to start off with, and then you want to bring it back as you speed up to about no less than 15 at the minimum. Yeah, the Xbox controller gets used a lot for trailers. It really is the secret weapon when it comes to creating good trailers, or good videos. Is there a train in there somewhere? Because I've got the throttle off, haven't I? So there's no smoke. There's no smoke without regulator. Am I doing the work or like a manager? I'm pretty much like a manager, but I do work as well. Yeah, I'm very busy with TS World. Very, very busy indeed. It's quite a nice scene here. Oop, 35 limit. Don't I code and set up stuff? I can do. I certainly have done that. To be honest, ironically, I've done, work type stuff. I did two patches for Train Sim 1 recently. So the workshop bug fix that came out, I did that. Oops, I'm priming. And there's another patch coming out soon, which is fixes a crash dump that I found. So that one's coming out soon. But that's just me doing messing about in my lunch break. Probably plays all the plans. No, and all these scenarios you see me play on the screen, this is the first time I've played them. Is this supposed to be it? It's not supposed to be anything except a run down the line. Will the patch help the performance of trains? No, all it is it fixes... I found a common cause of one of the crash dumps. If you're running on less than maximum settings. Affects the German routes. How long has TSW been in development? About 3 years, I think, now. Causing the dumps. I don't know the full cause of it. What I've done is I've looked. There was. I think that there are some assets that when you run them at a lower scenario quality section setting, they were causing it to read them in the wrong way. So in theory, it's a duff asset that's causing the problem. But I've no idea what the asset is or what exactly is wrong with it. What I've done is I found the bit of code that was falling over and I made it not fall over, so it copes with that now. You're playing Counter Monster Disco 50. Nice. I'm quite proud of Counter Monster Disco because I wrote some of the scripting on that one, so that all the way that the cobwebs disappear, and then the bit where you do the race and you've got to keep the counter going. I did that scripting for that as well. I quite like Counter Monster Disco. Skyhook did a really good job on the art style of it. It was so original. Very, very good. I am going to play it, Daniel. I keep forgetting, to be honest. I'm going to play it on the Halloween stream. Alright, 15 limit, stopping in at Arapar and Tarbet. Let's get in here. Chewy, thank you for the host. Welcome to Chewy's viewers. Am I going to wear a costume? That is the plan. I need to figure out whether I can actually do that or not, but that is the plan. Very good, White Man. Thank you very much. It's Julie! Hi, Julie. What are you doing up here? See you later, Mole Man. Thanks for stopping in. Get them doors open. I think I put a bit too much coal in. It's going crazy. forward. Cylinder's open. Time to go, Garlicide. Halloween streamer is Monday, October 31st. You didn't get on the train. No. I blame Julie. Right, let's go 35 limit. Ten miles. Goes up the hill. Pull the cut off back just a bit, let's try and preserve some boiler pressure. Do some more camera action. And the drone lands in the bushes. How do you turn, Matt, when you use shift A? Shift A? What's shift A? Life. Would I look at a route that's only 5 miles long and mainly industrial? Yes, absolutely I would. As long as it's got good scenery. Boiler pressure is now under 200 psi. But steam generation is rapidly catching up to steam usage. Oh, nice 4072, I look forward to playing that. I getting paranoid or is that going to get steeper? Round about there. I've almost caught up. Except we've only got 470 difference in generation and usage. We're now generating steam, folks. We're going uphill, accelerating and generating steam. Oh yes. Water's at 65%, that's not too bad. Let's get some boiler pressure in. Do you write your dissertation on education, or do you write an exploratory study into the traits that make Matt Pedalston fail, spad and pass through stations non-stop? I think the latter would be a difficult paper that people probably wouldn't even understand once you'd written it, so I'd go with education. Boiler pressure's going up nicely, need to keep an eye on that water level though. Still generating bare PSI, which is good. I can afford to throw some water in there, I think. Yeah, easy. You're doing your research now. Having researched the psychology, you're determined that the men in white coats are on their way. Let's ease off from the regulator, let it slow down. Power back on. Notice how the mouse landed on the emergency brake button, as if it was naturally expecting to need it. I'm doing alright for boiler pressure actually. We're about to blow the safeties. There they go. MC6443, probably yes. It's unlikely. Let me come away from here. It's unlikely you actually have four CPUs. It's more likely you have four cores. It's not impossible that you've got four CPUs, but it's unlikely. Even dual CPU machines are pretty rare. Can everyone hear me alright over this noise? Yeah, pretty extensive, pretty high expensive, pretty expensive. But I've got to actually slow down. Alright, we get back up to 40, although we'll then be going downhill. Goes. Of course you can be, Harrison. Go on, ask away. I'm going slightly deaf here. Can you turn this volume down? It's a great time for my ears to start working again. MOD property. Get off! Get out of my place! A little bit of brake on. Don't need all that water. Gently running downhill at the moment. Miles to Gala Key. head of gear lock. I love this view. Proper rail bashers view. Got the windy windies at the moment. Can you have a look at the route map? So you start, this is Fort William, and sort of the West Highland Line north goes up to about there, and it actually carries on up that way. Excuse me. This one goes south. This is us. Gaelic Head there, and then down to Helensburgh down there. You want to add some older electric stock and more modern routes. South London Network and the 4EPB. The 4EPB is really good fun to drive. Chatham Main Line with a BR Blue Pack. That's got the 2EPB in it and some other stuff. That's good fun to drive. 73 is great. It is a long route, actually. It's a very long route. I mean, this scenario is 65 minutes and it's about half the route. Yeah, great submission. I added this to the Western Lines of Scotland coaches just because I thought it looked so awesome. About a third of the length, is it? Yeah, it's a long route, this. Hey, Train Brain 84, welcome. Scenario after this, folks. Miles to Gala Cave now. Tyron Munt, welcome. Celtic Dan, depending on how good you are with video editing, I would suggest Sony Movie Studio. It's a lot cheaper than something like Premiere Pro, but certainly for putting videos together, and if you want to do super advanced stuff, I found it really, really good. I've since upgraded to Vegas, which is the Premiere Pro virtual equivalent of Movie Studio, but I did a lot of videos on Movie Studio and found it absolutely excellent. Hey Dunaman, welcome sir. Train slow down, let's check waters. Okay, I'm seriously overboard. Mind you, I'm not going to use the throttle at all since we finished. We finished coaling. Poland to Bulgaria. Yeah, interesting. Is that just on Pro Mods or is that with other add-ons as well? Right, this is Kyle Ken. It's Julie! Wow, she's caught up! Hey Julie, are you gonna get on or just gonna... There's two Julies. Hang on! Do I remember the 4SIG from STS? Vaguely, yeah. Head of gear lock. We start getting to the submarine base over there, look. Are the passengers based on creators of DuckTales? No. No, they're not. I'm not entirely sure what they are based on, whether just our imagination. Scottish roots, what's my favourite? I don't know actually. Probably West Coast Mainline North would be very high on that list because it's very versatile. Running West Coast Mainline North next. coast down the hill. Uphill stretch, about 6 miles now to the end. There's a submarine base down there. Big American steam, what, like Challenger, the FEF, Big Boy, they're all in there. There's the New Haven to Springfield line for it. There's an old one, a Horseshoe Curve's an old one. Can do some in cab. Sure. Well, this has got my cab light on. I'm about to turn it on. Has it got my cab light on it? No, this doesn't have my cab light on. Why doesn't it have my cab light on? Oh, yes, it does. There it is up there. I thought it was control L. Is it shift there? Control shift there? No. I can't remember how to turn the headlight. Go away. There it is, cab light. Every steam engine needs a cab light. It's pretty cool because you get all the shadows playing all over the cab, which is really nice. This is cool at night. Again, I added this. put a lamp in there and then you can turn it on. It took me ages to find a place to put this camera view because the normal location was about there. And the problem was that when you looked around, you could sort of, it was doing all of that rubbish. Because the normal camera view, actually, if you remember, is about there, I think it is, and you can't see down the end. And I wanted to be able to see down the front. And I found if I put the camera view at the back here, effectively in the gap between the tender and the. Then actually the camera view worked quite well and you've got quite a nice view of what's there as well. More importantly, you can see down the side of the boiler where you're doing. It's Bob 5053. How are you, sir? Yes, trackside, this is the Western Lines of Scotland, Black 5. Do you remember scaling the snowplow? Yes, I remember that, because you gave it, it was you or Mike or someone gave me the snowplow head for this Black 5. I don't think we've got the snowplow on this one. No, we've got a snowplow on one of the Black 5s. I seem to remember sending you pictures, or lots of pictures, and every time you gave me a bill, there'd be another picture with more lines on it. We're on level ground at the moment. Is this the most work I've done on a loco? I did all this scripting for the American ditch lights, so making them alternate, which actually was a lot more complicated than it sounds, because you needed to make it to where if you were coupled to a loco in front of you and you blew the horn, its loco, its lights would flash, and there could be one behind you or one on the other end of a consis. It could change while it was frozen, all sorts of complexities. So there was that. I did lots of tinkering with this one. I wouldn't necessarily say I did lots of work on it, but I did lots of tinkering on it. I just generally did an awful lot of work on the whole pack of Western Lines Scotland, along with other people as well. I mean, Western Lines Scotland has had a lot of work done for a lot of people, with mesh tools, digital traction, provided the brake van. Mesh Tools did something. Ubi provided the RMB coach. Getting close to where Francois grew up now. Ed did the sounds for the Black 5 and also the snowplow. Basically, I went crying to Ed one day and said, I don't want to use the default Black 5 sounds. He said, well, I can't get any more. I said, figure it out. And he did. Rue Village. Why hasn't there been any advanced previews? That's a question we need to ask Dovetail. I wasn't in charge of doing them. I did them when I was asked to do them. And they've just not wanted to do any. I'm sure there is a reason behind it. Some of it's just out of manpower, I think. It's just because we're all busy at the moment. Yeah, well, I was having a tough ride up the hill. It's growing, I'm not panicking. I let the biomass go down, mostly because I was getting deafened by that safety valve going off. Helensburgh Upper. Under a mile to go. Option to bolt the safety valve down. Yeah, that would be handy actually. In a sort of a blow up the train type of way. Getting slowed down now. We're on 1 in 67 and I'm trying to get the train slowed down. Back with a shocking crime to report, Moggy. One of your cookies and cream ice creams has gone missing. Dun, dun, dun! I've no idea where your track off or wouldn't work, Bob. There's certainly nothing being done in that area of the cove. Hey, the train guy, welcome. There you go, folks. That's the end of our run along the southern part of West Highland Line South. The southern part of West Highland Line South. It's very south. Right. And after this, West Coast Main Line North. There are still houses for Navy officers. Every 2 years, there's a French naval officer that comes and does an exchange, and your mother goes around and introduces herself as the only other French person in the village. So we get to meet a new French naval family every 2 years. Nice. Thanks, Francois. Okay, that was the end of that one. When it gets done. Let me just bring up Task Manager and see how the RAM situation is doing. Yeah, I'm going to restart the game. We're running at about nearly 2 gig of memory without even running a train. Back in a minute on the game, folks. I'm not going anywhere.